And if you're from the area, you may well know Dr. LaVerdiere from the area. Good morning, sir. How are you?
Good morning. Excellent.
Good, good, good. And what is your specialty?
I'm a radiologist. Yeah. I've done subspecialty training in vascular or interventional radiology.
Okay. And you, now are you somebody who diagnoses people with the condition we're going to talk about, which is HHT, correct?
Correct. Yes.
And it's more common than people know. And what people don't know about it is what it does and its treatment. And why don't you explain to us, first of all, what HHT stands for?
HHT is much easier to say than the name, which is hereditary, so it's genetic.
Yep.
Hemorrhagic, so you can bleed.
Yep.
Telangiectasia means the capillaries of the blood vessels are abnormal. They're either formed abnormally or they're absent. So if you have this entity and you have a telangiectasia, which is an abnormally formed capillary, and it's in your nose, you could bleed with nosebleeds. And that's a common way that people present. If it's in your intestine, you could bleed from below or above. But it could also create a mass if the capillary is absent. And that could be in your lung, it could be in your brain or liver.
And this is, clearly, this is a very dangerous situation. And do you... Can you go to a point in your life without even knowing you have it, like Jessica apparently did?
The majority of people don't know that they have it. And 90% of people with the illness don't know that they have it. The important thing is if you get diagnosed, then your family members need to get diagnosed, because 50% of it's an autosomal dominant. Men and women will have the disease equally. The important part is to make the diagnosis, to make everyone aware, and that's what's led into the awareness and the walk, which is on Sunday.
And the walk is on Sunday, and we'll talk with Jessica about that. Just another question for you, Dr. LaVerdiere. With this disease, what is, and it is a disease, right? I mean, that's, is it defined as a disease?
Correct.
And with this, how do you know you've got it outside of the fact maybe you get a few more nosebleeds or something like that? How do you know to get tested for it?
Yeah, that's a good question. The most common presentation is just frequent nosebleeds.
Really?
Which sounds innocuous, but it used to be, they've known about this illness for 100 years, and it used to be that they put it into the category of hemophiliacs because they were perpetually bleeding.
Right.
But then it wasn't a blood disorder of the platelets or the red blood cells. It was actually the structure of the blood vessels themselves which led to it. So it's had names over time, but HHT is much easier to say than all these other names.
It is, but I think it's important also to get that, the blood factor, in the, what was the word, the blood, where it was a second word, right?
Hemorrhagic.
Hemorrhagic. And when anything that has the word hemorrhage in it, you want to pay attention to that, and this does. Now, Jessica, is there anything else you want to impart on people who might think they know somebody who could have it? And are there tests for this specifically, and will most other tests miss it?
Correct. With Jessica, we were able to diagnose it on a CAT scan.
Okay.
Sometimes you can pick up the abnormality just on a chest x-ray.
Okay. Do you have to be looking for it, though? Do you have to say, okay, we're looking for this HHT now? Is it something you can miss in a routine exam?
Correct.
Wow.
Yes.
Okay, so if you're bleeding, having nosebleeds or anything like that, you ought to get checked for this.
Correct.
Because 1 in 5,000, you said.
Correct.
So that means 5 people in a 25,000 population, which is about what we have in this area, have it.
Yeah.
And you're one of them, Jessica. Now tell us, how has this affected you personally?
Oh, I'm doing great.
Yeah.
11 years ago, I went in for a different procedure, and where they did a CAT scan, and Dr. LaVerdiere caught it on the CAT scan.
Wow.
So that was pretty cool.
Yeah, no kidding. Now, what were your symptoms?
I had none.
You had none?
I had none. Yeah.
Wow.
So, I mean, as a child, I had few nosebleeds.
Yeah.
And maybe some headaches, but no symptoms.
Now, what is the prognosis for somebody with this? Is this a potentially fatal thing?
It can be if left undiagnosed, correct.
Especially, I would think, with intestinal and internal.
Brain or lung. Yeah,
no kidding.
Definitely, yeah.
And being able to tell, you know, if you go into the hospital for some other reason or you're under care for some other reason, say, hey, I have this.
Yeah, yes. Absolutely.
Beware.
Yeah.
That's amazing.
Yeah, so it's amazing. Pretty, a neat find for me.
Yeah, no kidding.
And my family.
We are so happy for you.
Yeah.
You know?
And yeah, thank you.
And there could be some other, I don't want to say ticking time bombs, but I mean, what else?
It's, take it day by day.
Yeah, but if there's somebody out there who has it, it
oh, absolutely.
Want to learn more
this
about it.
This is what we're doing, yeah.
Yeah.
So we're, it's, this is a new to this area.
Yeah.
So no, there's been no walk up here for it. So,
but there is a walk coming up this
Sunday.
Weekend.
Correct, yeah.
On Sunday.
All right.
At 9 o'clock, we'll start registering. And the 10 o'clock, the walk starts.
Where's it going to be?
Right at Coney High School.
Coney High School.
Yeah.
Okay. So you
yeah.
want to be there starting at 9 o'clock.
Yep.
HHT. And,
yeah.
and get checked. I mean, if nothing else, let this talk this morning encourage you. If you're thinking, geez, you know, I have
definitely.
Nosebleeds, and I don't know why. And
especially, at, you know, abnormally a lot of blood or,
yeah.
you know. Yeah, definitely something to see the doc about.
Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah.
Now, besides the walk, afterwards, you're having a lot of fun stuff going on.
We are.
Right?
We have some great raffle items that were donated, so we're going to be calling names for that. We have a DJ, so there's probably going to be some dancing going on.
Nothing wrong with a little dancing.
Nice no, that's right. Yeah. You know, some snacks and drinks, and it's going to be a nice day. So.
Terrific.
Yeah. We're excited.
All the details are at 92moose.fm. You just click on community, and you'll find the information there and a link over to the website as well. Yeah.